first winners of the 33rd Moscow International Film Festival were announced on Saturday morning in Kudo S20 Cinema. Viewer Sympathy Award was given to Montevideo Taste of a Dream by Serbian director Dragan Bjelogrlic.
Montevideo Taste of a Dream is a story about the extraordinary feat accomplished by young Serbian football players who will in the years to come turn into genuine stars, idols of their nation and true legends. The story follows their journey from the cobblestone streets of the impoverished Belgrade neighborhoods, their local football matches and an array of challenges they face up until their departure to the FIFA World Cup in Uruguay 1930. Inspired by faith, hope and vision, they become a team of prepared for great deeds. The initial doubts that surround their personal and professional lives is transformed into great friendships, promising love affairs and, most importantly, a united decision to prove themselves in Montevideo. The film is designed as a long-owed homage, a testimony about a time in which, among all other things, a small Serbia can become great thanks to football and its football players.
Montevideo, Bog te video.
Samo malo, malo bite tako, malo neću jako, malo bite samo nako. Samo malo, malo bite tako, malo neću jako, malo bite samo nako. Kada tebe vidim ja, ide sve do đavola, jo. Ti malena, vide ti se kolena, jo. Svake noći sanjam da si moja sva i svakog dana da te ljubim ja. Samo malo, malo bite tako, malo neću jako, malo bite samo nako. Samo malo, malo bite tako, malo neću jako.
Umjesto da šutiraju loptu, oni šutiraju sina Nikole Pašića, jebala svetih aralampija da vas jebom!
Kommersant magazine gave its prize to Heart's Boomerang by Nikolay Khomeriki.
The movie speaks about the guy named Kostya, who is 23 years old. He's working as an assistant of a machinist in the subway. One day, doctors tell Kostya that he has a weak heart and he could die any day. Kostya then decides not to tell anyone about his sickness. He's trying to live his life as usual, but instead starts to think more and more about true meaning of life.
Котик, у меня сюрприз.
Биться надо.
Я бьюсь.
For the second time during the Moscow International Film Festival history, the Network for Promotion of Asian Cinema, better known as NETPAC, jury worked out during the festival. The association gave its award to Revenge, a Love Story by Wong Ching Po. The film participated in the main competition program.
The movie investigates a serial killer who targets pregnant women. At the scene of yet another such murder and led by undercover detectives Jeff and Kwok Wo, the police comb the area and find unknown suspect, Chan Kit. They bring him in. Chan Kit remains silent throughout the brutally physical interrogation and is then released without charge. The movie progresses with the finding of the killer if Chan Kit is not the one. Russian film critics gave their second diploma to this film.
如果你多事，条靓仔翻唔到出嚟。
Russian film critics gave first diploma to a Pole Feliks Falk for his film Joanna.
Everyday life in the German-occupied Warsaw in the midst of the World War II runs between efforts to find a job and, therefore, something to eat and the efforts to avoid seizures carried on regularly by Gestapo on the streets. One of the days takes away a Jewish woman whose 8-year-old daughter accidentally manages to avoid a seizure, but now left completely alone, hides in the nearby church. Hungry and frozen and almost to death. It is Joanna, an ordinary middle-class woman waiting for her husband to return home for over 4 years now, who sees the girl. She feels a natural strong urge to help, but doesn't know anyone of the underground opposition circles who would be able to secure the safe home for the Jewish child. The gravest danger hangs over everyone involved as there is a death penalty for hiding a Jewish person. It is when Joanna has to decide for herself whether to engage or whether to stay safe. With this choice, the whole reality changes and lays bare before her eyes, leading to places she would never have expected she will experience.
Cinema Club's awarded Undercurrent by Árni Ólafur Ásgeirsson from Perspectives and ELENA by Andrei Zvyagintsev presented in the Russian program.
Undercurrent is the name of a frail Icelandic fishing vessel where the sturdy crew should be sure that a woman on board forebodes trouble. But far from it, the gloomy Icelandic fishermen do not throw the newly arrived lady into the first wave, like their less reserved colleagues would probably do. Moreover, when the skipper of the rusty boat decides to replace one of the crew who tragically left them during an early expedition, with his troubled knees, they do not show any particular emotional reaction. Though, as this hot pussy avows, she has slept with half the village before boarding the ship. It is not quite their presence of a woman's strains that complicated relations in the fishing crew, which gradually succumbs to claustrophobia and loneliness. The employee of the Department of Fish scraping toils as hard as men and in the evenings stares at the TV set watching porn blockbuster, Sperminator, kept on board as a preventive measure. The woman as a representative of a different world and a different life is not so much a catalyst as an observer of the disintegration of the male circle. Then misfortune really strikes. Lights go out, someone gets hurt, someone else chooses to become fish fodder. But on the whole, the woman has nothing to do with it. Special diploma of cinema clubs was given to Snowchild by Uta Arning. The Spanish film The Waves by director Alberto Morais was awarded the main prize for the Moscow International Film Festival, the Golden St. George, at the closing ceremony which was held on Saturday, June 2nd. The Fipresque jury also awarded the film. The movie speaks about Miguel, who starts a journey delayed 60 years from Madrid to a small town in the south of France called Argelès-sur-Mer, where thousands of refugees last stopped not so long ago. Getting through an unknown prison and forgotten past in his old car, he seeks out of a personal but certainly too historical reconciliation. The movie star Carlso Alvarez-Novoa picked up the Best Actor's Award.
cuarta, posición de I mayor.
He intentado arrancar, pero nada.
¿Que se le ha estropeado el coche?
Yo me llamo Blanca.
¿Y usted?
Miguel.
Él es David.
Quítame graves. Sube medio volumen.
Un momento. ¿Así?
Llevo a Barcelona.
No tenemos que esperar.
Está todo arreglado. ¿Se viene adelante? ¿Le interesan mucho esos temas?
¿Qué temas?
Todo eso del pueblo que salía en la tele.
El pueblo de la tele no lo conozco. Yo estuve aquí.
¿En Alemania?
No, es Francia, en el sureste.
¿Sale usted en la foto?
Sí, soy el que está al lado de la chica.
¿Eres su mujer?
No. Se llamaba Emilia.
Era muy guapa.
Critics' favorite, the movie Chapiteau Show by Russian director Sergei Loban, was awarded the Silver St. George, the jury special prize. Hong Kong's director Wong Ching Po collected the Best Director's Award for Revenge, a Love Story. The Best Actress Award went to Poland's Ursula Grabowska for her role in Joanna. The jury, which this year was presided by actress Geraldine Chaplin, gave its special mention to the Bulgarian film Sneakers, directed by Valeri Yordanov and Ivan Vladimirov. Sneakers, the debut feature of young directors Ivan and Valeri, was also one of the 17 selected for competition for the festival's prestigious St. George Award. The film exudes a contagious energy that reflects the zeitgeist of a generation, according to the critics. Sneakers tells the story of six young people trying to escape from the failures in their families, love lives and ambitions, fleeing the big city to settle at the quiet sea coast. Cinema Club's prize and diploma were also awarded to the film.
Every face is looking grimmer with holes instead of eyes, and that run is endless. That
dance still with us.
I have a heart in my chest. Not a croaking little frog. And now I'm walking so strong. And I'm not felt there anymore. I'm gonna fill my lungs now with the coldness of the air. I'm gonna take away.
The main prize of the Perspectives competition, which featured directors' first and second movies, was awarded to the Lithuanian-Hungarian co-production Anarchy in Zirmunai, directed by Saulius Drunga, and the jury's special mention was given to Bugs by Russian director Andrey Bogatyryov. Dan Fung Dennis' Hell and Back Again, a UK-US co-production, was awarded as the best documentary. Actress Helen Mirren was awarded the special prize for outstanding achievement in the career of acting and devotion to the principles of Stanislavski School. With that, it's a wrap-up of the 33rd Moscow International Film Festival. We'll be back shortly with the Karlovy Vary Festival. Stay tuned.